All right, fellas, what's going on? Denanu here, the man with the biggest and the most blackest privilege on YouTube. And in this video here, we're going to be talking about Mass Effect. Mass Effect Andromeda, the new Mass Effect game that's dropping, I think, next year, I think. And I'm kind of late with this one. I know the cinematic trailer dropped a few weeks ago, and being a huge Mass Effect fan, I figured I'd just give my thoughts on it and probably, you know, rant on it about it for 20 minutes. So that's what this video is probably going to be. Like I said, I'm a huge fan of Mass Effect. I played through all three games, beat them several times to completion, probably at least 5 or 6 times. And if I had to pick, Mass Effect is probably my favorite game from last gen. Well, not game, I'm sorry, franchise from last gen. You know, how would I describe it? The way the game makes me feel, I would say, is unique unto itself. I know I said it in previous videos, I'm a huge fan of sci-fi. Love sci-fi to death. But Mass Effect was that game, at least to me, that story that took you from game to game. I remember in the first game, you became a Spectre. You were pretty much learning about all the different alien races, fighting Saren, learning about the Reapers. And then in part two, you got killed. They brought you back. You learned more about the Reapers and about, you know, what they were trying to do with the Collectors. And then in part three, you were trying to rally the galaxy against, you know, the Reapers to fight them. And it's, by it being that big of an ongoing story, I loved it. Loved it to death, YouTube. Like, you guys just don't know. What I did was I had a modded 360, so I took like a PC game save and carried my save from game to game, and I, you know, edited all my choices to be a certain way, even edited my character. I think Mass Effect was one of those games that when I want to say part 2 and 3 came out, I recorded like the whole game for my YouTube channel and uploaded in like one piece, just like I did Dragon Age 2, and loved it. But anyway, we're talking about Andromeda. The trailer came out and, it looks pretty good. I don't keep up with the day-to-day news about the franchise or anything like that. But, normally basic big reveals, I normally keep my eye on, but so I don't follow everything. So I may say some stuff that I don't know. I don't know when the timeline takes place. I'm assuming from what they said before, this is going to be like thousands and thousands of years after Mass Effect 3. So Shepard's gone, Garrus is gone, fuck, because Garrus was like one of my hugest sidekicks that I loved from last gen. Gonna be sad to see him go. You know, plus Tally's gone, so my girl is gone too. It's like they basically made a huge departure from the older games so they can tell a complete new story. But I see some things in the cinematic trailer are the same. Like, you still got similar armor and everything. They still got the whole N7 thing going on. They got some alien race that kind of looks like the Collectors or something, or they look similar to them some kind of way. You still got Omni-Tools and everything, or some device that looks like an Omni-Tool. But I'm more interested in the story side of things, like, what's, you know, basically what's going on. It looks like you're fighting another robotic enemy. So I don't know if this is going to be like some cybernetic type thing, because it looks like you've seen them fighting like big cybernetic animal looking things. And so I really don't know what's going to be happening during a story, but I'm assuming they would have to have different races in the game, because in the other three games you had different alien races and things like that. But if this is going to be taking place in like another part of the galaxy that we know that we've never been to, or tell something completely different, they can't just have the same alien races. You know, you can't have the Salarians, the Asari, the humans, the Turians. You can't just have the normal races that the other games had. So you have to kind of do your own thing and do something different and introduce new characters and things like that and stuff like that. I see that they still got the Asari in there. I think I remember seeing an Asari during the trailer. I don't recall seeing like any of the other races, you know, in the game. I'm assuming they might be in the game. I don't know if they're going to be a part of your team or whatever, because I'm assuming it's going to have the same dynamic. You're going to have, you know, Captain Wannabe Shepard, you know, and he's going to be assigned with doing something, and you have to build, you know, your team and your ship to go do it. By them, you know, even though I know it's going to be like that, I don't want another paint by the numbers Mass Effect game. If you know, if you guys understand what I'm saying by that, like, I don't want them to just be like, oh, build your team, oh, build your ship, oh, go out here and do that, because then it just feels like I'm replaying the same thing with a different theme to it. I want them to do something different. I mean, I don't, maybe that's just me, but I don't know what they could do because then it wouldn't feel like Mass Effect. So I don't know, you know, how they would change that, but they have to change up that dynamic. I'm hoping that they kind of give you a set story, because Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3, it was all about basically your story as building Shepard and how you played through the game. One thing I like about Mass Effect is it's a different gameplay experience from person to person. Like, for instance, right? Pretty much most of my brothers have played Mass Effect. I got a younger brother and an older brother. They both played Mass Effect. And I played through it a few times too. My younger brother, he plays as a, let's say, when he made his Commander Shepard, he was human. You know, as pure human as you can get. Oh, humans don't have no powers. We build technology. That's what we do. So when he played his game, he picked, you know, just regular soldier, human Shepard. You know, that's what he picked, and that's what he ran with. Me, when I played my game, I picked, since I played through it a few times before I found my Shepard, so to speak, I chose a Biotic my first time through, if I remember right. And so I was like, I'm going to be the badass, you know, Jedi with powers and shit, right? And later on in the game, I think, you know, I finally, you know, during a couple of replays, I made a Sentinel. That was my thing. The Sentinel class, where you can make the holographic armor you had in part two and all that stuff. So it was, I like the, you know, I was like the in between, you know, the power class and the tech class. That was my thing. So I had powers and I had tech. I could, like, you know, pop people's shields and overheat their guns and things like that. But at the same time, I can also warp their minds and make them fight for me and enthrall them and all that kind of sort of stuff. But we have two separate play styles. Me, I played, I think the character archetype when I played was, I think it was Ruthless. I think I picked in part one, where it was like my character, you know, for me, you know, me, like me personally, if I was in Commander Shepard's shoes, I'm like, look, I'm here to save the galaxy. You're going to give me what I want because I'm saving everybody. You know, the ends justify the means. That's how I play. You know, I'm not going to be trying to be diplomatic to you. And I'm like, hold on, I'm saving everything here. So like, you better tell me what I want to know or I will kick your ass out the building. Like I did that guy in Mass Effect 2. But, what I'm trying to say is you have a different play style. Everybody plays the game differently. When I talk to my brother about how he played Mass Effect or ask him what he feels about the game, he has certain moments that resonate with him because he played it differently than I have when I did, because I played it differently from him. So what I'm trying to say is they write the story that way because it's open-ended to allow the player to have those experiences, right? But in doing that, it makes for a kind of... how would I describe this? It makes for a bland character personality, so to speak. Yeah, your character has a personality based on what you pick in dialogue and stuff like that. But let's say his character is, let's say, different than, let's say, Garrus. Garrus in Mass Effect, in the earlier games, you knew everything about his character as far as how he acted. Shepard, I can't say that because that all depend on how you played the game. If you were Fem Shep versus regular Shepard, the game was different. So you have to tell the story a certain kind of way, or what I'm trying to say is that forces them to tell a story a certain kind of way in order to get that. And in doing that, that kind of, you know, like, you know, lessens the character development that they could have with the main character. And, I don't know how they could fix that. That's kind of like a nature of storytelling. If you make something open-ended, they can't tell you the exact narrative that they want. And that's the thing with Mass Effect is do you take that out and just make a traditional game? Okay, you play John Doe going through this environment and you're just watching him do everything and you're going to get the exact narrative that they want to give you. Or, you know, because then that would make the game feel like just another sci-fi third-person shooter, you know? That's not Mass Effect. So, you know, they want the game to be about choices and consequences and all of that stuff. So I'm assuming they're going to do the same thing with this new one. I'm just hoping that they kind of tell it a different kind of way so that the character has growth to him. Because in Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3, I know I keep going back and talking about him, but like I said, I'm a huge fan of the series. Shepard's character over the course of the three games has gotten better. Like, if you go back and play part one, Shepard has a personality and a character in there, but it's mostly bland. Like I said, it's bland. It's not as well developed as, let's say, part three was. Part three, you had a lot of interactions between the different team members and you and the characters and things like that, to where it kind of you could feel the camaraderie between your team and what you had to do and everything. So with this new game, I'm hoping that they do that. I mean, I'm pretty sure they are. I mean, it's BioWare. Don't get me wrong. That's kind of what they do. But I just want them to tell it a different kind of way, because you see it in all their games. And like I said, I'm a huge fan of Mass Effect, but I've also been playing their games for years. Like, I played KOTOR, I played Mass Effect, Dragon Age. And if you play all of their games, or at least all of their games since like Baldur's Gate, they have the same kind of feel, and the you can tell it's a BioWare game is what I'm trying to say. And you can, throughout all of those games, you can see the same, not the same character types, but the same camaraderie in all of their games. Dragon Age, Mass Effect, KOTOR 1 and 2, or KOTOR 2. I know part 1, you kind of saw it, but it was more so KOTOR 2. You could see, you could feel that camaraderie between the characters and stuff like that. I think Mass Effect and, let's say, Dragon Age 1 did it the best. You know, Dragon Age 2, Dragon Age 2 and Dragon Age 3 didn't really do it all that much. Dragon Age 3 was cupbearer. It was far better than 2 with the character development and everything. But Dragon Age 1, they really Dragon Age 1, they really, you know, what's the saying that black people say all the time about cooking? They really dipped their toe in that one. Because in that game, that, like, I was pissed at Morgan at the end of that game. If you play Dragon Age 1, you'll understand what I'm, you know, why I was pissed at her. But like, she was like my love interest in that game, and then you're gonna come at me at the end of the game talking about, well, it don't have to be you, I can sleep with your best friend. I'm like, yo, you gonna do me dirty like that? It was like I felt betrayed, YouTube, like as if Morgan was an actual person, like my girlfriend in real life, and she told me some shit like that. Like, that's how betrayed I felt after playing that game. That's how, at least in depth, I get with BioWare games. So it's one of those things where I guess you have to have that in order to build that experience. And I just don't want them to make it the same traditional, you know, their BioWare formula, so to speak, into making the game. I don't want the new Mass Effect game to do that. And I want them to do all the different character stuff, but I want them to change it up at least a little bit, because, like I said, I've been playing all of their games. So if they don't change it, I'm going to be guessing like certain story beats and things like that. And I don't want to guess the story. I want to experience it for myself. So, I mean, I want them to change a little bit, but I don't want them to change the overall game. But it all depends on what they're doing. I mean, if they want to make a whole new type of franchise, maybe they're going to, you know, change up a whole lot. I mean, I'm pretty sure I'm going to love the game regardless, whatever they do. But it makes me really interested in to see where they're going to take the story. They have to introduce a new kind of threat. You have to have new alien races. I'm pretty sure you're going to get a badass ship like the Normandy. The only thing I can hope for is I want them to make a new Mass Effect universe and pay homages to the, you know, to the first three games. Like, I want to be on whatever the new Normandy is and discover a planet. And that's going to be like, oh, look, here's the piece of the Normandy. This is supposedly some old ass ancient ship that, you know, we don't know what it did. But, you know, if you're a fan of the franchise, you could be like, oh, shit, they found a piece of the Normandy. Or like, you know, that's what I want. I want to see like certain things or Easter eggs pop up in this game that were in the first three games. You know, even though it's thousands and thousands of years later, let's say like if the Geth are still around in like some ancient fashion or whatever. And, you know, although the Geth in this game could be completely different, but yet you know that they're a Geth. Or if I don't know if your save game is going to transfer over into this new franchise. I don't think that's the case. I think they may just start afresh. But like, if it did, I want at least certain decisions that you made in the first three games to at least have repercussions thousands and thousands of years later. That would be a really good thing for them to introduce. Another thing they got to come to the table with is music. I know a lot of times game developers, as a franchise goes on, music, they change composers for the music and things like that, and certain games suffer. I'm a huge fan of the soundtrack in Mass Effect, like especially part three. You know, if I really do hope that they can get the same composer to come back, because if they can't get, let's say, him to come back, and let's say they get somebody else, when you have a different composer and a different audio tones, it makes for a different experience, and it's not going to feel like Mass Effect. Prime example of that, of what I'm talking about. If you guys have played Halo 1, 2, and 3, go play 4. And it doesn't feel like Halo because they used a whole different soundtrack. Well, wait, was it Halo 4? Yeah. Halo 4 and Halo 5. They play, or audio-wise, they don't feel like Halo because you don't have the familiar Halo music. You know, it's that's just the way it is. I mean, they're decent games for what they are. Well, at least 4 was. 5 was a piece of shit. But music-wise, it doesn't feel like Halo. And that's the first thing you hit when you hit start on the main menu. Like, when I played Part 4 with a friend, and we were both huge Halo fans from way back when, and then played 5, we did the same thing. That was the first thing we noticed in the main menu. Like, why isn't the Halo music playing? Where's the Halo theme? You know? You know, at least a remix of it. Something. You know, you have to have something. You can't just go to something completely new and expect, you know, fans of the franchise to like the music and everything as if they like the older stuff. It's like, no, at least remix it. Like, they should remix that shit more than Square Enix remixes the One Winged Angel theme from Final Fantasy VII. You know, because every time they show Sephiroth, you know, they always, you know, have like a remix of his theme as the movies and games that he's been in, you know, since 7. That's how they should do when games have a main theme. That's how they should do it for the whole franchise. Either change it, remix it, you know, from game to game. That way it's still familiar, but different. You know, you can't just completely, you know, jump to something different. So I really do hope that they can get the same composer. Something else that I hope they get, I hope they stay with the art style that they had. And judging by the trailer, it looks like, they are. So I don't see nothing really changing it from there. I guess the biggest thing I can look forward to is, like I said, story. As long as they have the same writers or have similar writers that can come to the table with a great new story, then I think the game's going to be successful. I mean, it is what it is. I hope to God it doesn't get bogged down with EA's bullshit, because that's what kind of killed the ending to the last game. You know, they forced them to rush it out the door. And I know it's going to have multiplayer or co-op. I know they're bringing that back. I hope that they're not putting a lot of time into that and, let's say, skimping out on single player. I know game developers do that, and I'm hoping that they don't do that with Mass Effect. I'm hoping that with the last game, I'm hoping that EA seems to be changing. And that's weird for me to say, but they seem to be changing with a lot of their games recently. Like, you had Titanfall 2, all the DLC is free. Battlefield 4, it's only cosmetic DLC, type things. I don't think they're doing the whole battle pack thing, but I could be wrong. But I know they didn't do that with Titanfall. So it seems like they're trying to be better as a company. So hopefully they don't introduce some microtransaction bullshit, you know, because that's, you know, because they kind of had it in Part 3. I'm hoping that maybe they cut it out of Andromeda so that you don't really experience none of that. I'm hoping EA don't say, okay, build the game a certain way, because then that would kind of fuck up with the story that they want to tell as a company. So I'm hoping basically what I'm trying to say is I'm hoping that the game, when they release it, is what they want, that it's 100% complete, no tacked on microtransaction bullshit, and they are not cutting stuff out to make DLC. They're giving you the story that they want to tell you, you know, from beginning to end. And if they want to have DLC later, have that be after the fact, that's fine. But I don't want cut out missions, because Part 1, 2, and 3, they all had, oh, look, here's this DLC. They cut out races and missions specifically for DLC, and it definitely showed. So I'm hoping that, you know, they don't do none of that. And I know that's more of an EA thing telling them they have to do that. And that's just the nature of any job or any business. You have to do what your bosses tell you or otherwise they'll fire you. So I'm not knocking BioWare as a company for doing that shit. That's just business. That's life, really, in general. That's the way it is. And so I can understand where they're coming from. I'm just hoping that when they release the game, everything turns out perfect. Because I already know the game's going to sell. The game's going to make money. It's going to print money when it comes out because Mass Effect is a huge franchise. So that's not, you know, I know the game's not going to flop. I'm just hoping that it doesn't fall into the trap of having a weak story, because then the game, you know, everybody's going to look at it and be like, oh man, this game fucking sucks. The older games was better. And that's something that with the franchise and sequels and stuff you have a problem with, is people love the first thing they put out because that was the first time they were introduced to this universe or to this franchise. And then with the later stuff, they kind of fall out of favor. And then, you know, because they have nostalgia glasses and have like this such high regard for the first thing when they were introduced. And then they kind of half hate everything else because they feel as if it's not better, even though it could be. So that's just been my thoughts on it. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. My name is Denanu, the man with black privilege. And I will see you guys in the next commentary video. Peace out.